Welcome. In this video, we're going to look at creating a brand new tracker project and understanding some of the tracker project settings. The screen you're seeing right now is the dashboard, and this is the screen you'll see when you first log into Tracker. From here, you can create a project by clicking on the Create Project button in the upper right-hand corner. I'm going to click on that now. And from here, I can enter a name for my project and select the account where this project is going to live. An account is separate from your login. A login is associated with a person. An account is something that you may have joined when you first logged into Tracker, if you joined a company account, and it may be something that you created when you first set up Tracker. But an account you can think of as a file cabinet that holds projects, just like a file cabinet holds files. So I'm going to select my account, and then beneath that, I can select my project privacy. That's the visibility that this project is going to have. If I select private, that means that only people I invite to this project will be able to access it. If I select public, that means that anybody with the URL to this project can view the project. Still, only project owners and project members will be able to edit the data, but anyone can look at it. Public projects tend to be used by students and open source projects where visibility isn't a concern. I'm going to select private because that's probably what most of you are going to want. And then I'm going to click the Create button. From here, I am now in my brand new Tracker project. And to go into the project settings, I'm going to show you some of the things that you may want to set up in your new project before you get to work. So by clicking on the More button, you'll see that here I have project settings, along with a project profile, integrations, and some other options that you may want to take advantage of. If I scroll down, you hear you have the option to toggle on or off that public access if you want to turn on or go back from that public visibility. And down here under iterations and velocity are some settings that you may want to configure. Here you can set what day of the week your iterations will begin on, with Monday being the default. You can set a time zone for your project if you choose to. You can set your iteration length between 1 and 4 weeks, with 1 being the default. You can set a point scale for your project. So this is the number of points that you will assign to your stories when you estimate them. So story points are something like a t-shirt size, a small, medium, large, or extra large, that give you a relative assessment of the amount of complexity, the amount of uncertainty, the amount of risk that a story may have. Linear, or a 0, 1, 2, or 3 scale, is the default within Tracker. Some teams like powers of 2 or Fibonacci. That tends to be more if you're doing a larger iteration, more than 1 week, and you can accommodate larger stories. If you're doing a 1 week iteration, a linear so that you have smaller stories is typically recommended. There is also a custom point scale, so if you have a different point scale that you're already accustomed to using, you can select that and then enter in whatever values you're used to using. I'm going to stick with linear, but I wanted to show you that option. Beneath that, you will see a setting for initial velocity, and that lets you set how many points of story points Tracker should use for your very first iteration. After your very first iteration, Tracker is going to look at the number of points that you completed, and it's going to plan your future work based on how many points you actually did. But for that first iteration, we don't have any completed work to look at, so you can take an estimate of how many story points you think the team can do for this first iteration and enter that value here. Beneath that, you'll see that there is a setting for velocity strategy. And this is how many iterations do you want Tracker to look at for your previous iterations. And this is the estimate that it's going to use moving forward. An average of 3 iterations is the default. So that means Tracker will average your last 3 iterations, and whatever that average is moving forward is what Tracker is going to plan for your current iteration and all of the stories into your backlog. And it won't let you plan for more work than Tracker thinks you can accomplish. The next setting lets you see the number of done iterations to show by default. And then you can see a setting here of whether or not you want Tracker to automatically plan your current iteration for you. Unchecking this means that you can actually determine for yourself how many story points you want in the current iteration. I'm going to go ahead and leave mine checked because I want Tracker to plan for me. One thing to note is if you uncheck this box, Tracker is still going to plan the backlog for you automatically. This setting only applies to the current iteration and planning that. Coming down below, there are some other settings about whether or not you want to have points on bugs and chores, allowing API access so that you can use the mobile apps, enable incoming emails, hiding email addresses, and so on. And there are read more links if you want to learn more about it. Looking at the sidebar, there is also a setting for a project profile if you'd like to update there with some specifics about the project. On integrations, you can set up integrations for this project. Here you'll see any webhooks that you may have already configured. Your project owner or administrators can recover any deleted stories, should you have any. And here you'll be able to configure custom story templates, custom review types, and import and export stories from CSV. So that shows you a little bit about the Pivotal Tracker project settings, creating a new story. I hope this was helpful. Thanks for watching, and be sure to check out some of our other videos so you can learn more.